Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Trying to get messages to you to try and say to you that we were trying to sort Kitty out so that she wouldn't get trolled on. But wow. Wow. Wow.
Wow.
Seriously, Alley Cat, you of all people. Wow. I'm disappointed.
Wow.
I am disappointed after everything I've tried to tell you about this guy and what he does. Seriously? And you want to sit there on a platform with the guy and believe what the... Wow!
Wow!
The guy is sexually obsessed with me. The guy does it with everybody. Haven't you ever listened to anything I've ever told you? I mean, seriously, I could bring multiple people on here that will tell you, innocent people that have never committed a crime in their life, will tell you what this Plisco is all about and what he does. And you still have the guy on your platform spouting his lies and his bullshit. Wow.
Wow.
I am absolutely dumbfounded. I am shocked. I am shocked. I'm absolutely gobsmacked. I'm flabbergasted, to be fair. Now, I mean, I'm not raging. I'm just very disappointed and very angry. You of all people, Ali. You of all people. When you've had trolls yourself. And I've supported you as well. After everything that we've all gone through with this guy. And you allow this guy up on your panel? I mean, wow!
Wow.
Wow! Do you know what this guy does, Ali? He even done it to Jupiter. He even done it to Moon. The guy is a weirdo. He is nothing but a weirdo. I mean, hasn't anything that we've told you been a warning about it? I mean, the police know what the guy does. They're actually watching him. They're monitoring him. They know what he does. It's only a matter of time. And then everything I've told you's lot, the truth, as I like to call it, will come out. And then you lot can all say, sorry, Fat Dan, sorry, Fat Dan. Sorry, Fat Dan, we didn't believe ya. Sorry, Fat Dan, we didn't believe ya. Well, by then, it'll be too fucking late. Because then I'll fucking turn around and say, I told you, Mugso. Plisco is a dangerous man. And it's actually a crime called fuck hate. Do you know what Plisco actually does to his victims? What he does, right, he goes around, picks a vulnerable person, right, or this is how he obtains his victims. He will go along to his victims' families on Facebook and things like that, and he'll search out things, get to know a little bit of knowledge around the background of his victim. And then he'll go onto his victims' websites or whatever, Discord or Facebook, YouTube, whatever. And he'll either pretend to be a dead loved one or to pretend to be another member of the family just to get into your account so that he can see who you've got on your friends lists and things like that. And that's when he starts spreading the shit. He's like what you call a cordyceps. He's a viral disease. He's a disease. And that's how he legally hacks into your systems. That's what he does. And then if they realise what he is, they try and fucking warn him off and he threatens them. And then he'll say, oh yeah, they're a nonce supporter, blah, blah, blah. And then puts their faces up on his little nonce board. Alley Cat, seriously, wow. You of all people. Wow. I never thought for one second that you would believe or listen to an ounce of fucking crap that guy comes out with. I mean, come on. Like, right, listen, right? The police can come to my house at any time, day or night, right? They can come and take my PlayStation 4, right? They can take my mobile phone, and they can take my tablet. Well, not my tablet, my iPad, sorry. They will know instantly that I've got nothing on there to do with child porn or anything like that. I've got nothing to hide. The police can even check up with my internet provider, which I've been with for over 25 years now. Yeah, I'm with Sky. I've got nothing to hide. You see, because what people like Plisco don't realise in their little fuck minds, yeah, they don't realise that when you upload, download, receive or send anything, your internet provider, it's all recorded there. That's the law. You know, ever since the terrorism days, they changed the laws. And most countries in this world have signed up to that law. It is fact. It is a law. I mean, seriously, wow.
Wow.
I am so fucking shocked. I can't believe what I've witnessed today. I can't believe what I've seen today.
I don't believe it.
Wow.
Wow.
You of all people. Wow. I am so shocked. I am so shocked. I have never, ever spoken to a child.
Well, I can't really comment on that since I'm a boy.
I love love, can I see your toes?
Can I see your fanny?
All the friends that I've ever been friends with from the PS3 onto the PS4, I am still friends with today. So, at the end of the day, no one comes up on my friends list at all. I've got nothing to hide at all. The police know exactly who my friends are on my PlayStation. I'm so shocked. I cannot believe it. I feel like I've been kicked in the stomach and kicked in the teeth and kicked in the bollocks. I cannot believe you of all people would allow this guy up onto your fucking panel chatting his bullshit and lies. Wow. Wow. But I'm not worried. I'm not fussed at all. Because when the truth does come out to prove that I'm innocent, right, never been convicted, never been arrested, nor will I ever be arrested, because no such thing has ever happened. I've never exposed myself to anybody. Now, there was one video of me on my phone where I was actually talking actually to someone, one of my carers, and I put it on my Facebook channel. It was not Paul Fairclough at all. But Paul Fairclough got hold of it. Now, Paul Fairclough was not a child when I knew him. He was well over the age of 18. And the police know this anyway. I've got fuck all to hide. I cannot believe. Wow, I am so, so disappointed. You of all people. I am just so, wow. There's just no fucking words to describe it. There really isn't. There is just no words to describe how I feel. I don't feel angry. I feel sad and disappointed that you of all people would sit there and allow Plisco onto your panel. Now, one, I used to know Rick Berry a little while ago, about a year and a half ago. And yes, I did defend him for a short while because I didn't know the extent of anything about him at the time. But once I realised what he was all about and all this shit with his husband, I dropped him like a sack of shit. And I've never spoken to him since, and I won't do. Never. Now, I mean, this is fucking ridiculous. And you're sitting there with this weirdo that's made misery of people's lives. And you're sitting there with that guy on your panel. Well, I can't believe, Sally, that you just sold your soul to the devil. You have sold your soul to the devil. And everybody else that's on that panel with you, you have just sold their souls to that devil. Because he is an evil incarnate. That guy is the devil, reincarnation of pure evil. And you have just sold your soul to that man. You have just sold your fucking soul to that man. Wow, I cannot believe it. I feel like Victor Meldrew now saying, I just can't believe it. I really don't. I cannot believe you of all people, Alley Cat, you just sold your soul to the devil. To one of the worst human scum there is on this planet. I went over to Brian Hell's channel not to get involved, like I've always said on that channel. And Bleeding Hearts, I've always gone onto that channel just to keep my head low, keep my mouth shut, and I stay out of their beef. I don't have beef with them. Whatever their beef is with other people, it's none of my business. It is none of my damnness. Unless it involves me, it's none of my business, and I stay out of it. And the reason why I go there is so that it stops the trolls from following me around. That's the reason why I go there, Alley Cat. That's the reason why I go there. But Alley Cat, for someone like yourself in positions that you're in, I never thought for one second that you would sell your soul to the devil. I never thought for one second that you would sell your soul to pure evil after what that guy does. And not just to me, he's got thousands of victims. Absolute thousands of victims. The police know what he's doing. They're watching him. I mean, Plisco was only up on someone's channel the other day, crying his fucking eyes out. Why ain't the police arresting Fat Dan? The guy is obsessed with me. The guy is absolutely obsessed with me. And let me just explain about something that I brought up earlier on. It's called fuck hate. It's actually a crime. Do you know what Plisco does? He gets sexually obsessed with some of his victims. And when he riles them up, he'll sit there masturbating over it. That's what he does. He gets different chat rooms and factions to fight over his victims. And he sits there masturbating over it. The police know what he does. They're watching him. That's how they know. It's actually a crime. It's called fuck hate. And that's how he gets his jollies. It's how he gets his kicks. He's a fucking no good son of a bitch with a pair of glasses that's probably about 5 foot tall, sits there at his PC, picking out all day his little victims, and he sits there with a mouse in his left hand and his cock in his right hand. And you just sold your soul to an evil bastard like that by what you're doing now. Wow. Wow. I cannot believe. I am just absolutely dumbfounded. There is no words to describe fucking, well, I am absolutely gobsmacked. Absolutely fucking gobsmacked. And he does it with everyone on YouTube because he's a sick, twisted, demented man. And let me tell you something. And when I say this, I am under no grandeur or under any delusion. Yeah, but let me tell you something. I am not under any investigation whatsoever by the police. Because if I was, they would have told me. And I was even told that last week by an officer. I am under no investigation. So when you hear people like Plisco chatting his bullshit, then perhaps you'll learn that everything I've ever told you, Alley Cat, has been the truth. This guy is part of a trolling ring, but he's the worst of the worst. And you, my friend, I don't think I can class you as my friend. You're not my enemy, but I don't think I can class you as my friend either. Because you've allowed this guy onto your panel to chat shit about me. And you sit there and you believe it. You sit there and you believe it. I am so, so shocked. I even spoke to one of your friends the other day because I was really concerned. Because I tried to get hold of you and I couldn't. I was so concerned, you know, because you've got health problems of your own. And even to this day, I won't put that out on the internet. I won't tell the world because it's not my place. I still protect you, Ali. From this day to the last. Although I feel that you kicked me in the teeth and the bollocks, I will always defend you. Always. But I just don't know how to take you now. I don't. I'm just so sad and disappointed that you've sold your soul to the devil. I cannot believe that you've done this. I cannot believe that you've done this. And the only reason why I tried to get hold of you last week was to let you know that I got Kitty over to that side to stop her from being trolled. Nothing more, nothing less. That was all. And to find out how you were doing, because I was concerned. I hadn't heard from you for a while. And when I tried to get hold of you, I couldn't. And I thought that was strange. But Alley Cat, seriously? I was a friend to you. And you turned round and sold your soul to the devil. You have sold your soul to the devil, pure evil. Well, to be fair, I don't know anymore. I don't know what to say. I'm sad, confused, and disappointed. I'm disappointed. After all the shit that you've gone through in your private life as well, I am so, so surprised. I've stuck by you. I thought you were someone that I could trust. I thought you were someone that I could trust. I thought you was a friend. I feel... Do you know what? For once in my life, I actually feel like crying. And I'm not ashamed to say that. I actually feel like crying. I do. I feel like crying. I never thought for one second that you would sell your soul to a real true online stalker, an online stalker and an online weirdo, an absolute monster, which will get his comeuppance in due course. He'll get his comeuppance in due course. He'll get his comeuppance very, very soon, actually, to be in fact. But I never thought for one second that you would sell your soul. Ever. That has shocked me to the core. Wow. I am so, so disappointed. Hurt, to be fair. I've been betrayed. I have actually been betrayed. But, as they say, life is life. Life is life. I know Plisco's watching now. Someone's just sent me an email that he's watching. I don't care. Plisco, your day's coming. Your day's coming. Because I've been told by the police, actually, a few days ago. They know where you are. It's only a matter of time. And they're gathering evidence. They've got their evidence from me. They're gathering evidence now from your other victims. People I don't even know. So, your day's coming, Plisco. I can promise you that. And do you know what? When the time comes for court, I'll even be prepared. I will actually be there in that courtroom specially so that I can look you right in the eye after the shit that you caused to me, you nasty little bastard. Whoever you are, and I don't know and I don't care, mate, but I do know one thing. I do know one thing. The police have said they know where he lives now. They know where he lives. So I don't know and I don't care. But when that day comes and the day of judgment comes in court, I will personally be there in that courtroom to make sure that I'm the last thing he sees before he gets sent down. Because he is definitely going to jail. That I already know. I already know he's going to jail for a very, very long time. And that's not just because of the shit that he's done to me, but the shit that he's done to other people. So, his day will come. His day will come. But I am just so, so disappointed. Alley Cat, I am so fucking disappointed. I never thought that you would sell your soul to the devil. You of all people. You of all people. But it is what it is. It is what it is. It is what it is. But I'm not just someone that people can say that I'm slagging you off, Ali. You know where to contact me. You know how to contact me. I want to hear this. I want to hear your side of the story. I want to hear your side of the story. I really do. I really, really do. I want to hear this from you. I cannot believe for one second that my eyes have deceived me. I just hope that what I've witnessed today and what I've heard today, I just hope that all this is a bad dream. Because I never thought for one second, Ali, that you would be someone that would sell your soul to the devil. I still can't believe it. I cannot believe what my eyes and ears have witnessed today. I cannot believe it. I cannot believe it. I just can't believe it. I at first I thought this was just the devil playing tricks with me. But are my eyes and ears just deceiving me? I mean, was there an agenda behind all your so-called live stream? I mean, I didn't watch your live stream. I just got sent a clip of it. I just can't. I can't. I cannot. If it's what I've heard to deceive my eyes and ears, then no, I want no part in the devil's work. I play no part in the devil's work. I don't choose that path in my life. I stay off of that path. But after what I've read in the message, please, please tell me that it's all bullshit. Please tell me that what I've heard today in that clip was just the devil playing with me, trying to give me a test. I mean, was this God testing me today? Was God testing me today? Because I still don't believe for a second that what I've heard was real. You of all people, Alley Cat, I am so, so surprised. I am shocked. I am shocked. There's just... for once in my life, I can honestly say that I'm absolutely dumbfounded. I am, well, beside myself. Absolutely beside myself. I am absolutely beside myself. Absolutely beside myself. I'm absolutely shocked. I'm completely, absolutely dumbfounded. But it is what it is. So, I just can't believe it, Ali. I just cannot believe for 1 second. I just cannot believe it. I am just so dumbfounded. I just cannot believe it. I am just literally dumbfounded. But like I said, I mean, I've got nothing to hide anyway. I mean, if I've ever spoken to a child and all this, like, then it, you know, it would have been registered on my internet provider and everything. So the police have checked it. They're more than welcome to go and check it, you know. So, Plisko is just a very, very sick and ill man. And the police have already said that. But he'll, once he's been sentenced, he'll get the medical help that he needs. So that when he comes back out again one day to be part of normal civilization and society, he will never bother anybody else again. So, like I say, I've got nothing to worry about. I've got nothing to hide. The police can come to my house anytime, day or night. And the weird thing about it is, I'm still friends with all my friends on the PS3 that I used to know on the PS3, which are now on my PS4. I've got nothing to hide. Nothing to hide whatsoever. Nothing to hide whatsoever. The police can come to my house anytime, day or night. In fact, they don't even need to do that. They've got my online details. They always have done. Since the day that they come and took my PS4 and I had it all back, they've had my online details from then onwards. They know my passwords. They know my account. They can look into my account anytime, day or night. I've got nothing to hide. Never have done, never will do. See, with Plisko, he's just a very sick and twisted, very not well man. He's just not very well. But he will get the help that he needs. He will get the help that he so desperately needs. So I'm not worried about that. That's why they've said that when they do get with him and take him to court, when he gets sent down, that's the reason why he's going to get sent down for so long. It's for the fact that they're going to give him the treatment that he needs. He's a very, very sick individual. And it's not just me that's got the police involved with him. There's other people as well. I'm not going to mention who they are because they're not here to defend themselves. But there are loads of people on YouTube that have got fucking things going on with Plisko. Plisko is not a very well man. He's not a very well man. He's got problems. Psychiatric and mental problems. The police have already said that. Deblo, you don't even want to go there, girl. But I don't worry about shit like that now. Yeah, I've said some dumb things in my day. But I'm nowhere near the level that Plisko is. So. But it is what it is. But it is what it is. Anyways, I'm off now. I've done what I needed to say. But like I say, Plisko will get the help that he needs one day. And I just hope he takes it. Well, he wouldn't have a choice anyway. So, peace out, guys.